2020 Optometric, your vision is their focus. Whether you're 5 or 65, Dr. Thomas Casagrande will get to know you, your lifestyle, and vision needs to ensure that your contacts or eyeglasses are a perfect fit and the right prescription every time. With the Valley's largest selection of eyewear, 2020 has over 2,000 frames, including top designer brands like Coach, Tiffany, Prada, Ray-Ban, Oakley, and more. Eye exams start as low as $89, so call or stop by to schedule your appointment today. Hi, I'm John Malice. Welcome to this live edition of Connect With Me on the showroom floor at Ventura TV on this day. Glad you're with us here on a Monday morning. Usually it's on the air off the presses. Not today. Got an expert on the house today talking about real estate in a special program tomorrow regarding all the police shootings. We'll talk about that in just a moment. 436, MeTV Option 11. Today's program is sponsored by Dr. Thomas Casagrande. And it's Monday morning here on Connect With Me on ETV Fresno. Glad you are with us. This is a live broadcast, so you can call in at 436-ME-TV, option 11. We're here until 11 o'clock in the morning, of course. Normally, it's on the air off the presses. Today, a special program talking about the real estate industry. Now, let me tell you what happened here. I know that you probably watched the program last week, and we promoted the fact that Mark Sheeran was going to be here talking about his trip to Germany, talking about the media. Well, that changed because I wanted to talk about the recent police shootings that took place last week, both in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, and in Minnesota, and then the Dallas shooting, of course, five officers being shot dead. That was going to take place today, but I couldn't get all of the parts or all the people together at one time here today, so we're going to do that program tomorrow. As a matter of fact, Jackie Parks of the Fresno Police Officers Association is going to be here tomorrow, along with Pastor Tobias Brookins from Bethesda Apostolic Church, along with a member from the NAACP. That'll be on tomorrow's broadcast. You can call in then as well. We'll talk about the police shootings. We'll talk about Black Lives Matter. That protest taking place over the weekend on Saturday caused a lot of commotion. We'll talk about that as well. I shot some video of that, and so we'll show you that video tomorrow. It was an incredible sight out there. Then on Wednesday, another live broadcast with Ronnie Paul. He's going to be here flying home with Ronnie Paul. A little surprise for him because knowing that he's such a big Dodger fan, I recently covered a Giants game. We'll talk about the Giants' 6.5 game lead over the Dodgers as they take the All-Star break Tuesday in San Diego. This is the break. The Giants with the best record in baseball at 57-33, despite all the injuries to third base, to second base, to right field, to left field, and a pitching staff or a relief pitching staff that has been rather inconsistent, to say the least, this year. They got the best record in baseball, and last night, Madison Bumgarner came close to pitching a no-hitter. He took a no-no into the eighth inning. He ended up with a complete game one-hitter. So Madison Bumgarner, who wants to take part in that home run derby on Tuesday, will not. His manager won't let him. We'll talk to Ronnie Paul about that on Wednesday. So don't forget tomorrow's program, a very important one. We'll talk about the police shootings, but for now, we have an expert in the house. We're going to talk about the housing market. And the housing market here in Fresno is healthier now than it has been in years, my friend. That's according to some local real estate experts. But the question is, and the bigger question, what does all that mean for you? Let's roll the videotape, show you exactly what I'm talking about. Does it mean that it's good for the buyer? Does it mean it's good for the seller, the real estate agent, or who? Who reaps the biggest reward in this case? Is it a matter of opinion or fact that if you buy a home now, you are getting the best deal than you've gotten since the housing collapse of a couple of years ago or a few years ago? We'll put that question to our expert today. On the flip side, if you're selling and you need to get out fast, who has the advantage, the seller or the buyer? For the past few months, we've been hearing about bidding wars in Fresno, and there's plenty of inventory as builders have now slowly cut into the shortage of new home construction. In fact, the hottest homes are now selling for about $240,000. A few months back, the Fresno County Economic Development Corporation said the real estate market in Fresno is moving in a healthier direction, and those buyers seem to be local families, not outside investors. A spokesperson for the Fresno Association of Realtors says that sellers are actually selling their homes with equity. The average price of a medium home here in Fresno was nearly $193,000. Home values have gone up about 6.2% in the last year, and experts say it's going to go up even more as we take a tour of this beautiful home here. Just about everything is available online these days, so the experts say do your own homework before you go talk to a realtor. Know what you want, know what you're talking about, and come in with knowledge. Live in our studio right now, my friends, is Don Scordino, a real estate agent with Realty Concepts. He is here to take your calls. If you're buying, if you're selling, 436-ME-TV, option 11, is the telephone number to remember right here on the program today. So you can call in and ask your questions. Maybe you own a house and you're on the verge of selling it, but you're thinking in the back of your mind, wait a minute, maybe I want to rent this thing out and make some money. What's the advantage of doing that? So, 436-ME-TV, option 11, a lot to get to here on the program today. Back with our guest in a moment. At 2020 Optometric, your vision is their focus. Whether you're 5 or 65, Dr. Thomas Casagrande will get to know you, your lifestyle, and vision needs to ensure that your contacts or eyeglasses are a perfect fit and the right prescription every time. The Valley's largest selection of eyewear, 2020 has over 2,000 frames, including top designer brands like Coach, Tiffany, Prada, Ray-Ban, Oakley, and more. Eye exams start as low as $89, so call or stop by to schedule your appointment today.
Find movies on over the air channel 13.3. Movies. Our name says it all.
Back here on the program, connect with me on MeTV Fresno. And just a reminder again, Jackie Parks will be here from the Fresno Police Officers Association tomorrow, along with Pastor Tobias Brookins. He's from the Bethesda Apostolic Church. NAACP will be in here talking about the police shootings. In the meantime, we're talking about real estate today. 436-ME-TV, option 11. Don Scordino is here from Realty Concepts. Welcome to the program, Don. Good to see you. You're a first-time guest.
Yes, I am. Thank you for having me.
Hey, no problem. So I want to get right to it. So the interest rates right now are approximately what?
In the mid-threes. And keep in mind, I sold real estate back when they were 17%. So this is incredible.
Wow. How, and that was what, back in the 70s, late 70s?
Actually, 80s? It was the early 80s.
Early
80s. About 1981, I think, when it really got crazy.
That was high. Reagan was in office at that time, of course. He had just gotten elected.
Right.
Yeah, he was just elected, of course, in 1980, but then took office in 81. So so what does that mean? So they're low. Okay, what conclusion can we reach from that?
Well, affordability is much greater now. People can afford a much bigger home. They can afford to actually buy a home. And even if it's a so-called seller's market, the interest rates make it a buyer's market.
So it's a buyer's market right now rather than a seller's market?
Well, that's a good question. It's actually a buyer's market because of the interest rates. A buyer can go out and maybe purchase a $300,000 home when normally they could only afford, let's say, a $250,000 home. However, yes, it's a seller's market because inventory is short. So
it's still short.
Oh yes, it is.
Even though the new home construction, even though builders are kind of cutting into it slowly but surely, I said that in the monologue. How big a shortage is there right now? That's the question.
Mm-hmm. We try to measure it by a factor called month supply of inventory. 6 months supply of inventory, meaning if no new listings came on the market for the next 6 months, it would take us that long to absorb market with the amount of buyers. Right now, we're around 2 months supply. So you could see where that would tell you that it's definitely a seller's market with only 2 months supply. Even though you have new homes being constructed, really not enough for the demand.
Interesting. So when there is a shortage, does that mean that there are bidding wars? Because I've heard in the last 4 months there are some bidding wars going on in Fresno because there aren't enough homes. And when somebody sees a home that they really like, they're going to pay a little more for it than they would because they know the next there's somebody staying behind and waiting to get that house.
I like to refer to it not as a bidding war because that's not a very nice term. But I like to look at it as a change in negotiating tactics. So,
what do you mean by that?
And that means a buyer should go in with their best foot forward in their initial offer, rather than going in trying to nibble and whittle away at the price, and then find out that there's other offers, and then find out they have to go up. That's when it turns into a bidding war. But if you go in with your best foot forward, then you'll be fine. And if you don't get the home, and you did go in with your best foot forward, then it's okay that you didn't get it, because then you were going to have to pay more than you could really afford.
All right. Caller, go ahead. You're on the air. Go ahead, you're on the air.
Yes, I have a question about, I just inherited a threeplex on Christmas Tree Lane. It's over by the big red church over here.
Yeah.
And I was hoping that you can give me some advice on if I should keep the properties, the three individual houses on the lot, the big Christmas tree down the center median catty corner to the church, and it's a unique property, but is it something I should hold on to and then maybe sell later, fix it up and sell it later? Or
answer your question,
let me stay there, caller. Let me interrupt just for a second, Don. Okay. Caller, what do you suspect in your mind? Have you had it appraised? What's the house worth?
Thank you.
What's the house worth, caller?
Pardon me?
What is the house worth? Have you had it appraised?
Yeah, it's been appraised at the threeplex has been appraised at $145,000.
Okay.
But I think it's pretty low.
Yeah. Well, I don't know what the square footage is either. I have no idea.
There's two bedrooms and one bedroom. Fireplace, basement. Two car garage.
Okay.
First of all, I would say the right time to sell is going to be a personal matter more than an investment matter, because nobody rings a bell at the top of the market or the bottom of the market. So it's really a gamble if you're only doing it for the investment. But let's say you're done with the property as far as your own personal usage. Now's a good market to sell it in. And I think you can maybe even, if you clean the property up and make it appealing and financeable, you may find out you can get more than that $145,000.
Yeah, I was going to say $145,000 sounds awfully low for a house that's either on or near Christmas Tree Lane. Those houses over there are very expensive, as you well know.
Well, and the way I look at it, as far as renting that out, that would be three very desirable rental units. So yeah. I could see probably getting $900 a month rent on them, depending.
Or more. Yeah, depending on the size.
The size, the bedroom count, and such.
Yeah.
But that's a very desirable area, walking distance to Fresno City College. It's going to be very desirable that way. So, I could see somebody easily getting $2,000 to $2,500 a month income.
Let's say, like, we can use this caller as an example. He's got this triplex or tripleplex, whatever you want to call it. And so let's say you can get $200,000 for it. Here's the question that people always have to ask themselves. Okay, if they sell the property, they're going to get $200,000. They have to get some of the real estate agent that they may have to pay capital gains on that, so they may end up with $100,000, $150,000 in their pocket. What will they do with that money? How will they invest it? Or is it better to keep the house because nothing is a better value, at least at this point, than owning a house. So how does one individual make that determination? I know it's a personal choice, but how do you make it reasonably?
With investment property, they should have a good conversation with their accountant, because if the capital gains that they may have to pay might determine that, you might say, no way am I paying that in taxes, and so you decide you're going to keep it. But that's a great question you're asking, John. What do you do?
Because a house is an investment.
Sure. And probably will go up over the years. Maybe not short term, but long term, it just seems to do that. So, if you're not going to do anything valuable with that $150,000, then keeping it might be great.
Yeah, if you're just going to go out and spend it buying a car or a boat or, you know, taking expensive trips, I mean, that's your prerogative. It's a free country. But if you want to use it wisely, is it more wisely to keep the house as an investment and rent it out? See, that's the thing. And do you consult a realtor with that? Do you consult an accountant? Do you consult who?
You should consult both. And a good realtor that has experience with investments is a great resource. And I think that realtor can give you the questions to ask your accountant.
Oh, okay.
So maybe not the answers to the tax questions, but can help you come up with questions.
So do you want to get a realtor, and I got to take a break here, but do you want to get a realtor who maybe has a little more experience under their belt, such as yourself? Or what about a young realtor that's maybe only been in the business 2 or 3 years?
Well, I was a young realtor up until last year.
Yeah.
And so I'm going to say that young realtors
have a little bit more experience.
That's the thing. You want to make sure they have the experience. Or as when I was young, I made sure I went to the right people to ask questions and get the information. Exactly. Okay. It's fine to say, I don't know the answer to that, but I'm going to find out for you.
I'll bet you still do that, as I do.
Often.
All right. Talking with Don Scordino, he's from Realty Concepts, 436-ME-TV, Option 11. A lot more to get to here on the program today. Today's program sponsored by, who is it? Dr. Thomas Casagrande, 2020 Optometrics, back in just a moment.
Want to create something extraordinary? Create perfection. Our lifestyle appliances make it easy. KitchenAid, Ventura TV appliance, and you. When only the best will do.
At 2020 Optometric, your vision is their focus. Whether you're 5 or 65, Dr. Thomas Casagrande will get to know you, your lifestyle, and vision that your contacts or eyeglasses are a perfect fit and the right prescription every time. With the Valley's largest selection of eyewear, 2020 has over 2,000 frames, including top designer brands like Coach, Tiffany, Prada, Ray-Ban, Oakley, and more. Eye exams start as low as $89, so call or stop by to schedule your appointment today.
Back here with our expert today in real estate, talking about the real estate market. So I said in the monologue, I said the housing market here in Fresno is healthier now than it has been in years, according to who?
Well, you know, I'm very active with the California Association of Realtors, and we're blessed to have a chief economist there who does nothing, the whole department does nothing but provide numbers for
what
us.
What is making it healthier, and define that term? Because
okay.
I've read that, and so when you say healthier, what does that mean? Does that mean people are buying homes? Does that mean people are selling homes? Does that mean people are staying in their homes longer, no foreclosures? What does all this amount to?
I think a healthy balance, of buyers being able to buy because homes are still affordable, sellers being able to sell because they have equity in their homes and they can do that. And if it's a healthy market, you're not going to have the foreclosures that we had a few years ago when we had a very sick market, not a healthy market.
Yeah. What else? What are some of the other key indicators of a healthy market? Would you say interest rates?
Well, interest rates surprisingly are not that big of a factor. I mean, and anybody
really?
Would say, yeah, you would think so. But we've had some of our healthiest markets when interest rates were double what they are now, 6.5%. I remember a great healthy market back in the 80s, and interest rates were around 12. So it's really supply and demand. And if there's enough buyers that want to buy and enough sellers that want to sell, and able to buy and able to sell, that makes a healthy market.
Aaron, very interesting here. I want to roll a piece of videotape of a house up at Shaver Lake. It's called the Tour of Shaver Lake, the house there. And I want to take you inside this house. Now, do you do real estate transactions up at Shaver?
I don't.
You don't, but you know people who do.
Exactly, and I refer them out.
You refer them out. But I just want to take you on a tour of this house here, and then we'll show some other video of some houses here in Fresno. This is a beautiful house. So somebody, the reason I want to show this is because of the natural beauty of this house, the updated kitchen and all that. So an average buyer, should they be even looking at a house like this if they can't afford it? Or
no, because real estate is a long-term investment. You have to look at it that it's something that will work for you for the next 5 years and possibly 10 years.
So are you wasting your time, Don, if you're looking at a house like this and you just can't? I mean, this house looks like a $1 million house. I don't know. But if you can't afford that, can't you just walk in and maybe get some tips on maybe what you want to do with the kitchen, maybe the bathroom of a house that you will eventually purchase?
Sure. Education is not a waste of time. So if you're doing it for the purpose of educating yourself on what you can do, then that's not a waste of time. And it's not a waste of time for the realtor to show it to you either, because that's building that relationship.
Right. And even though you can't afford maybe to buy a house like this, you may look at the design, the interior, the way it is, and say to yourself, okay, I may not be able to do this in every room, but the kitchen, for example, gosh, that kitchen countertop is really cool. I wonder where they got that. That could be a factor.
Yes, and that's part of that education process. So I really believe buyers should look at homes that are in their affordability range, but also a little above and a little below for the education factor, so that they see that, oh gosh, for another $25,000, I could move this up.
Let's say I owned this house, and I came to you and I said, look, this is a really expensive house. This thing is worth $1 million, $1.5 million. It's up at Shaver Lake. I need help, Don, on trying to price this thing. How do you price a house like this? How do you know what the right price is to appeal to the right buyer? How do you know?
The realtor has to put themselves in the mind of the potential buyer and see what else they would compare it to. And we have data in our Fresno Multiple Listing Service where we can go back and find similar types of properties that did sell and also that are currently on the market that a buyer would be comparing to. And then really appraising is an art, not a science. It's not a mathematical formula. So
it's not 100% accurate is what you're saying.
No, it's not.
It's a guess.
It's hopefully an educated guess.
Yeah. So you can't just say, okay, look, this house is really, you can't pick this number out of thin air. Where do you go to pick it out?
The realtor should be able to help you price it.
Okay.
I will spend several hours sometimes prior to listing a home trying to find out why certain homes sold for what they did. I'll drive by them and say, this one doesn't have the great curb appeal. Maybe that's why it sold for less money than what I'm suspecting my subject would.
What about comparables? Would you look at comparable houses in the area and then judge those houses by what you're seeing there?
Yeah, comparables are probably your best source of good information to help you make that educated guess.
Yeah, very interesting. And so the market is healthier, but it hasn't rebounded totally, right? Or has it? Or has it? Because I don't want to answer my own question. Mm-hmm. I want to let you answer it. Is it back 100%?
I believe that it is, but if you look at numbers, it's not. But I think that
numbers would you be looking at?
If you compared it to 2005 prices, we are not back to what the prices were in 2005.
But should we be?
No, because that was an aberration. We were coming off of what I refer to as the steroid era, just like in baseball. housing was on steroids. Right. People were able to buy with no money down. They were able to buy without even verifying their job. And the no money down part wasn't so bad on its own. The VA loans, which are no money down, are some of the best performing loans out there. That's because those borrowers are proud of their ability to get that loan. But when you could get no money down without even verifying that you have a job or income, that was too much. There was no ability to repay verification.
All right. Carr, you're on the air with Don Scordino. Go ahead.
Yeah, Don, let me ask you a question here. I know from a fact that a lot of the owners in Sugar Lake area and those areas, they rent their homes for like $1,400 a week. Okay, this is, you know, maybe some families want to stay there for a week, whatever, and up in the hills or whatever. But a lot of the owners would rather rent them for, let's say, $1,400 for 1 week. And that's how they really get their lot of income. I'm scared to buy real estate in the Shreve and all that because of all the fires that have occurred here and there, you know. So you're actually taking a chance at buying a home. And the home that they're showing now is a beautiful home and all that. But at the same time, you as a, you know, let's say a seller or trying to help someone sell their home, you have to realize if they take a, you know, cut and pay, a lot of it has to do because a lot of them are scared that, hey, something like this could happen with the fire or whatever. But I know a lot of owners would rather rent for $1,400 a month a week and get money out of it in a month's time. I mean, you're paying more than a mortgage. So what do you think? Do you think I'm right or wrong?
Well, I think you're right. I think owning real estate is a great thing. And I heard something long, long time ago. There's two reasons for owning real estate. One, to use it, and the other is for the investment part of it. Now, as far as investing, I'm a believer in that. I've been an investor for the last 30 years. And I believe it's a great retirement income. It's fantastic. There's lots of tax benefits for it. There's a lot of heartache behind it too, especially when the tenant moves out and leaves it trashed. But if you look at it as a business and you can get past that, it's worth it. Now, it's not for everybody, so you got to have the. My uncle told me this one when I bought my first rental home. I was complaining about the tenant not keeping up the yard, and I complained too much. He said, sell it. Just sell it. I go, why? I just bought it as a rental. He goes, if you're going to get a heartache over it or an ulcer over it, it's not worth it. So, okay, I'll get over it. So, and that was 30 years ago. So, owning real estate as an investment, I think, is fantastic.
Wow. Okay, got to take a break here. Don Scordino is here from Realty Concepts. We'll delve more into the housing market here in Fresno, in the Central Valley. Your phone calls are more than welcome. 436-ME-TV, option 11. Dr. Thomas Casagrande, 2020 Optometrics is our sponsor today. We're back with more of a program in a moment.
The new Frigidaire Professional line at Ventura TV Video Appliance. Enjoy generous-sized cooktops and saute or simmer with ease, while true convection ovens offer even baking and juicy roasting perfection. Foods stay their freshest in spacious refrigerators with convenient controls and clear filtered ice and water. Easy to clean surfaces reduce fingerprints, and the quietest of dishwashers makes cleanup a snap. The new Frigidaire Professional line at Ventura TV Video Appliance.
At 2020 Optometric, your vision is their focus. Whether you're 5 or 65, Dr. Thomas Casagrande will get to know you, your lifestyle, and vision needs to ensure that your contacts or eyeglasses are a perfect fit and the right prescription every time. With the Valley's largest selection of eyewear, 2020 has over 2,000 frames, including top designer brands like Coach, Tiffany, Prada, Ray-Ban, Oakley, and more. Eye exams start as low as $89, so call or stop by to schedule your appointment.
Back here on the program, 436-ME-TV, option 11, talking with the real estate agent from Realty Concepts today, Don Scordino. Go ahead, caller, you're on the air. What's your question?
Well, you know, what I am calling about is we were talking to our insurance broker the other day, and he said that places like that that is, you know, up in the mountains where they've been having a lot of fires, problems like that, that you can't even get those places insured anymore.
Oh, good question. That's a great observation on your part. So, Don, what about that? Are there some homes in the hills, not maybe necessarily Shaver, but other places, including Shaver, but other places where you just can't get insurance now?
Well, you can always get insurance in the state of California. It might be very, very expensive, but the state has a sponsored insurance group called, I believe it's California Fair Plan. So, and it's not the best insurance, but at least it's there. And that is something.
Can insurance companies deny you?
Sure.
They can.
And they do.
And they do.
Yeah.
Really?
Yes. In fact.
Because of why? The what?
Well, and I've seen insurance companies deny coverage because they don't want to do an older house, or they don't want to do a home that has a wood shake roof, or a home that has galvanized pipe. So they,
like in Northeast Fresno.
Yeah. Yeah.
With all the problems they're having. But from what I understand, by the way, we're doing a show on that later this week. And I understand that's not necessarily the piping. It may be the city may be at fault with that. But go ahead. I interrupted.
No, no problem.
Go ahead.
It's your show.
No, so, go ahead.
So, in fact, here's a common one that they'll turn it down for is if there were prior claims on the property for water leakage. Because then there's that fear of possible mold.
So you're talking, it sounds to me like you're talking about risk. If the home is at risk for anything, then you're out of luck?
Not out of luck. You can find an insurance policy, and it may cost you more. I had one on one of my rentals. I was denied twice. They said it was an older home. Another company said it had galvanized pipe. I found a third company, and it ended up being cheaper.
Really?
And I've been with them now for 15 years and had zero claims.
How is the coverage, though?
It's good coverage. I'm totally covered on it. And like I say, despite those two companies turning me down, I've had no claims.
All right. Caller, go ahead. You're on the air.
Hey, Don, I just wanted the viewing public to know that John Mallows cut 4 inches off the legs of that chair that you're sitting in.
Yeah.
That, John?
Yeah.
I even know who this is.
Who is it?
I used
sure,
to
you
work
know
with
who it is, John.
30 years ago.
Hey, now tell them some horror stories about what things are doing in San Francisco.
Well, you know, I'm not much of an expert in the San Francisco market. In fact, that's a good one. Realtors have to know where their geographical competence is. And if, like, the reason I don't go to Shaver Lake is I don't know the value of a view. Because most of my business is here in the valley. But if I can refer it to somebody that I know, I can help my client get in touch with them and form that relationship with somebody who knows those things. Same thing in San Francisco.
Okay.
Same thing in other states. I have a referral going on right now in Atlanta, Georgia. I'm not licensed to sell there, but I'm very much involved in the transaction through the referral agent.
What is, thank you, caller, are you still there?
Owner sold their property and put the money in the bank. They draw zero interest on it. Whereas if they kept the triplex and rented it out, they're making money.
Yeah, we talked about that, yeah. But that's up to the owner of the house to determine that. It's a personal decision, basically.
It is. And basically, you want to weigh the balance between risk and reward.
Yeah. What is the responsibility of the real estate agent? And the second half of that question is, what's the percentage, what's the cut that you get?
Good questions. First of all, the responsibility. The Department of Real Estate, or now called the Bureau of Real Estate, has a minimum out there. And they say, you have to do this. You have to be a fiduciary, an agent. You have to have your client's best interests put first. Mm-hmm. And that means you take care, you look for red flags in a property. Maybe we walk through a property and see something that maybe the seller didn't disclose, maybe because the seller didn't know about it. But with our experience, we're able to see these red flags and at least have it looked into. And then to negotiate fairly, here's a big one, to manage expectations.
What does that mean?
Sometimes when a seller lists a property, they think they're going to get 10 offers. They think they're going to get 10 offers in the first 2 days. That's not always the case.
In fact, more often than not, that's probably not the case.
Right. Maybe if you were in the heart of San Jose, that might be the case.
Yeah.
But we're in the Central Valley where things are more normal.
Yeah. Caller, you're on the air. Go ahead.
I love your smile. You smile with your lips and your eyes and your eyebrows. That's really cool. I have a question for you. You obviously have rental, so that means sometimes you have to replace things.
Yeah.
What brand of oven would you recommend for a wall oven? And it would be electric. And the problem is that it is a 27.5-inch oven. But the hole itself is actually 24, so the 27.5 actually does fit in there because that's just the front part of it. Yeah. I bought a Kenmore, and I can't cook with it. It's burning my food, or it doesn't cook the food, so I'd like to have your opinion.
Oh, great question. Thank you.
Yeah, I've got two answers for that. First of all, as far as the brand and the quality, I think it needs to be consistent with the value of the home and the neighborhood. So maybe you wouldn't put a Wolf Series into a $150,000 home. But the other thing is, that goes beyond my expertise. So what I've learned to do is rely on trusted people. So I do have an appliance person who repairs things for me and sometimes recommends replacement. And so I go with their recommendations. The realtor can't be all things to everybody.
Yeah, but your responsibility, though, to either the buyer or the seller is honesty, right? That's first and foremost.
Yes.
And would you say that most agents do abide by that rule?
Oh, yeah. Most do. We're like any other profession. There's a bad apple once in a while, but we do have a strong code of ethics that can take care of them.
All right, caller, you're on the air. Go ahead. What's your question?
Off. I didn't get to hear your answer on the oven.
Oh. Okay. Well, the answer on the oven, you never heard that? Do you have your TV up?
I was on the line, and all of a sudden I was just disconnected. I don't know why.
Yeah, I thought we were done with the call. I'm sorry about that. We disconnected you. But any other questions? Donald, go ahead and repeat the answer. You go ahead and get off the line and go listen on your TV set. How's that?
I am in a different room, so I can't do that.
Oh, okay. All right. Sorry about that. Thank you. And then hang on.
Okay. The two answers to that question would be, first, make sure that the appliance and the quality of it is consistent with the neighborhood and the valuation of the home. It's a different answer for $1 million home versus a $200,000 home. The other one is find trusted people or trusted stores that you rely on to give you that information. I don't know all the appliance manufacturers that well to say this is perfect for this home. That's beyond my expertise. But what I have learned how to do is ask good questions from good, trusted people.
Okay, did you get that, ma'am?
Yeah, but that doesn't help any. That Kenmore is sure a piece of junk, I'm sorry to say.
Okay, well,
thank you.
Okay, all right. Sorry about that. Hey, let's put our disclaimer up real quick, and then we'll take a quick break here on Connect With Me. And the disclaimer means that Don Scordino of Realty Concepts came of his own free will today. He did not pay us. We did not pay him. He is an expert in the real estate field. Obviously, you can call in at 436-MeTV, option 11, and get his expert opinion about the real estate market if you're buying, you're selling, you're renting. And, you know, it may not be, we'll talk about this on the other side of the break, it may not be a great time for you to buy right now. What about the rental market? Does he know anything about that? We'll get into some other factors about building a house. And what about the equity in your home? Are you borrowing too much against the equity that you have in your house? That can turn into a major problem if you're not careful. Thomas Casagrande, our sponsor today, 2020 Optometrics, back in just a moment.
Not sure what you're watching? Want to see what's coming up next? Or just want to browse what's on without hassle of flipping channels? Your wish has come true. Now you can view schedules for all the digital TV channels available in the Central Valley. Get local weather updates and forecasts, and listen to nationally syndicated Biz Talk Radio, all on KVHF 4.1. Rescan your TV now, then tune in to digital channel 4.1 to start enjoying the all-new TV guide.
At 2020 Optometric, your vision is their focus. Whether you're 5 or 65, Dr. Thomas Casagrande will get to know you, your lifestyle, and vision needs to ensure that your contacts or eyeglasses are a perfect fit and the right prescription every time. With Valley's largest selection of eyewear, 2020 has over 2,000 frames, including top designer brands like Coach, Tiffany, Prada, Ray-Ban, Oakley, and more. Eye exams start as low as $89, so call or stop by to schedule your appointment today.
Back here on our program, 436, MeTV Option 11. Caller, you're waiting patiently. Go ahead, you're on the air.
Yes, sir. I'm in a situation with the family estate, and one of my sisters is an attorney, and she took the trust as a acted as a trustee, but she never invested in the estate. I mean, and I believe that the trustees are supposed to increase the value of the properties. And in 2006, it was appraised at $3.5 million, and then now it's was appraised at, you know, $1.2 million. So, and she's selling the property. She sold the properties like extremely cheap, you know, and there's no, there was no way to control her actions. And I was hoping that maybe you could give me some advice as far as, you know, what to go, you know, how to approach the situation that she put us in.
Okay. Yeah, stay on the line there for a second. Go ahead, Don.
Okay, first of all, that it sounds like that may turn into a legal question as to whether or not she did a proper job, in a honorable job as the trustee. Now, you have to keep in mind that we had a great recession and values of a lot of things went down. So to have something of the same value today as 2006, and especially if it was real estate heavy, wouldn't be possible. But you gave some numbers that were had a pretty wide range there. So that might end up being more of a legal question than a real estate question. In fact, it might be worth a few $100 to invest in seeing an attorney and just getting their opinion.
Yes.
And just like a trustee has really a duty, a fiduciary duty, the same as a realtor has to their client. And that's one of the utmost integrity and fairness and trust. If that's been violated, it's a legal issue.
Go ahead.
I should approach the in a legal manner because I believe that even commercial properties in the Tower District my parents owned, and she sold it so cheap, I mean, for $119,000. I mean, all the properties were paid for, and they've immigrated from Italy and worked very hard for what they have and help her their children to live comfortable. But it seems like this one sister had and her husband was in worked for a bank that was in a trust department management. And so they got together. He, you know, I think he, I know he manipulated her in doing different, what she shouldn't do.
Yeah, it sounds like we can't solve your problem here on the show today. You probably have to go seek an attorney on that issue there.
Yes, but it's something that needs to be, is it a criminal? Is it an attorney?
Probably
have
to ask an
real estate ethics, an attorney ethics?
Yeah, I don't know. Don, I don't know if you can answer anything.
Well, I think it would start off civilly, but if your attorney found out there was intentional and malicious intent there, it could turn criminal.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay. All right, Carr. Okay.
Thank you. Thank you so much, gentlemen.
All right. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. I want to roll a videotape. It's called Working on a House. They are working on a home in this videotape, and they're working on a lot of houses right now. Now, new building construction, we're looking at it right now. talk about it. Is it on the way up? Is it status quo? Is it stagnant? What's the status of our new home construction here in the Central Valley?
The Central Valley is really growing as far as new construction, but we need to. Keep in mind there was very little
caller.
There was very little building going on between 2007 and 2014. So that was a 7-year gap. So we didn't have new product helping to fill the demand.
Right. So basically, right now, new construction is slow?
Oh, no, I wouldn't call it slow. They're very active. They're selling
active.
Homes.
They're more active now than they were a few years ago.
Yeah. But they're still playing catch up because there was virtually no building for 7 years. And
zero building for 7 years. Zero. Nada. Nothing.
I think there was one.
There was one.
Maybe
over
two.
By your house.
Yeah.
Over by
maybe
your house.
Two.
Caller, go ahead. You're on the air.
Hi. I have a home I'm considering renting out, but I've heard horror stories from several people that are renters. They have rental properties. They've had squatters come in. They've had people get upset and tear up doors and walls and all kinds of things because they're being evicted. Anything that I, as the homeowner, can do, any clues you can give me to protect myself and my property?
Yes. Meet the people face-to-face that you're going to rent it to. And you can look at their credit report, their credit app, but don't forget your gut feeling. That's why the most important thing is you meet them face to face, see what they're, get a good feel for what they're like, and go drive by not only the house that they're in now to see how they're living, but also call the landlord from two homes back and find out what they were like. They'll give you a true answer. The one that's in there now might have a difficult time of giving you a truthful answer because they're wanting to get rid of them. Possibly. So if you do those things, I think you'll end up with a good one. And
you're not getting a management company to do it for you.
Oh, yeah. And that's a personal decision. I think a management company is excellent for most people because it's very easy to get personal and emotional about your home, especially if you lived in it before. And you might, the fact that they killed your sago palm, you might get really upset over that, but yet the rest of it was good, where the management company would do it on a more even keel. But there's a lot of horror stories, but it's still worth it. It's like any job. You go to work someday, and there's bad days. That's why they call it work.
Hey, let's go to a quick break. We'll come back with more of Don Scordino's interview, 436-MET-OPTION-11. If you want to ask a question, Thomas Casagrande, 2020 Optometrics, our sponsor today. Back in a moment.
It's Sully and Russ on the Big Biz Show.
It's your biz.
And maybe you'll start listening to Baldwin McCullough.
Before you make any money moves, check in with the Brain Trust.
And you are starting your week off right.
Biz TV is now on KDHF Channel 4.6.
At 2020 Optometrics, your vision is their focus. Whether you're 5 or 65, Dr. Thomas Casagrande will get to know you, your lifestyle, and vision needs to ensure that your contacts or eyeglasses are a perfect fit and the right prescription every time. With the Valley's largest selection of eyewear, 2020 has over 2,000 frames, including top design brands like Coach, Tiffany, Prada, Ray-Ban, Oakley, and more. Eye exams start as low as $89, so call or stop by to schedule your appointment. All right, back here with our expert who's been selling homes since 1976. That is a long time. You graduated from San Joaquin Memorial, went to Fresno City College, Fresno State, worked as a mortgage broker at one time. Are you still considered a broker?
Well, I'm a real estate broker.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
What's the difference between that and a regular real estate agent?
The test. So as a real estate broker, you take a more an expanded test, but then you can supervise other agents. As a salesperson, you can't have your own business.
Gotcha. All right. Caller, you're on the air. Go ahead.
What about solar panels? Peterson Dean is offering a wonderful discount for his 33rd anniversary. Is solar, those panels, I've seen a video where it damages the inside structure of the roof, like the beams and things, and that many of them, you read the contract, and they won't cover it after 7 years, it starts to leak. Now, what's the truth on solar? Is it, does it really damage your roof in the interior? Does it leak?
Wow. Yeah. Go ahead, Don.
The answer is they better not damage the roof. And if you can prove it was their fault, then obviously, and you know, with a third-party roofer saying, hey, they cut
well,
a hole too big.
What advice do you give home buyers, or even sellers for that matter, on solar? What advice do you give them?
Oh, that's a very tough question because I believe in solar. I want to underline that. I do believe in solar. However, the industry is in its infancy, and there's a lot of problems out there that it causes for not only home sales, but sometimes insurance. So most people that I've encountered don't realize whether they're in a lease, a purchase, a power purchase agreement, or an actual purchase. I ask people, well, okay, do you own the system? Oh, yes, I do. And then it's come to find out they're in a lease. And now,
how does that affect the sale or buying of a home?
Greatly, because some lenders, in fact, your biggest lenders, which are through Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac, will not take a home that has a solar lease on it that is superior to their new loan. So in other words, you may not be able to sell your home except to a cash buyer.
If you have a solar panel on that house that you're trying to sell.
A solar lease or a power purchase agreement. So that's why it's important that you understand what you got.
If a buyer buys a house with solar panels, do they have to take over that lease as well?
Well, technically the seller can take it with them, but that's not practical. And
so normally, typically it goes to the buyer.
Yeah, and if the buyer won't assume the lease, because there could be $40,000, $50,000, here they are paying $300,000 for the home, plus assuming their $40,000 or $50,000 lease. Not every buyer is going to do that, and in many cases, the lender won't allow it.
I can see where it complicates the issue greatly.
Yeah, that's a good way to put it.
Yeah, it complicates it greatly. All right, let's roll the videotape. Homes number two. And we'll sift through this and talk a little bit about, we already talked about what makes a market healthy. Remember that early in the program?
I do.
But what about home equity? Let's say you got your house paid off and you're sitting pretty and you're saying, wow, you know, I want to go borrow some money against the equity that I have in my house. And, you know, I got a house worth $500,000 and I've got it paid off, so I'm going to go borrow $300,000.
Okay.
Is that dangerous to do that? And if so, why?
It is dangerous. And first of all, I go back to my ancestors. If you have your house paid off, they would have told you, salute. I mean, that was a great
thing. That's Italian, right?
Yeah, that's Italian. And that's a great thing to have your home paid off. So hopefully you appreciate that. Now, here's the problem. The Fresno Association of Realtors did a three-year survey during the foreclosure era. 54% of the foreclosures came from cash-out refis. So it wasn't people buying too much home. It was people over-borrowing on their home and not being able to afford the new payments.
Borrowing against the equity that they have.
Yes.
If you have, let's say, I'm just using that figure. Let's say you have $500,000 equity in the house, and all of a sudden, let's say you overextend that, you could lose your house.
You sure could.
And people have.
54% of the foreclosures in Fresno County came from that exact scenario.
Last year?
No,
or just
from
over the
2007 through 2009.
2009, okay. All right, so over a two-year span, it was huge.
Yeah, and here's the scary thing. You got all the advertisements out there again saying, pay off your high-interest credit card. It's cheaper. You know, if you have a 12% credit card that you bought a dress and a TV set on, that's $1,200 interest for the year. But you should have that paid off in 1 year. If you put it on your 4% 30-year mortgage, think how much you're paying thousands and thousands of dollars to pay that off over the next 30 years. Sure, your payment's less, but it's a trap you can get yourself into.
Right. So to get a loan now, you can't get 0% or zero money down. Right? You can't get that.
If you're a veteran, yes.
Well, if you're not a veteran, those days are gone.
Yeah. However, they are back with 3% down, 5% down. But okay. The good part now is you have to qualify. And that's why I don't think
how much different is it to qualify for a house than it was in 2005 or 6?
In 2005, you just had to raise your hand, say, I want it. And they'd say,
you got it.
You got it. Tell us how much you make. We're not going to verify, so tell us whatever you want.
Now?
Oh, gosh. Now I feel sorry for the people.
Yeah, they put you through the ringer.
Yes. You got to write letters explaining why you were had detention back in high school, everything.
Yeah, so they scrutinize you much more closely and wisely in most cases financially to make sure that you don't skip out on those payments.
Mm-hmm. The biggest thing...
Do they check how secure your job is?
Oh, yes. Well, they certainly do. And if you're on a temporary basis, you're not going to qualify. Yeah.
So if you have a temp job, part-time, forget it?
Maybe not forget it. There's a loan for everybody, but you may end up paying a higher interest rate. And it may be worth it to wait 6 months until you are permanent and you can get that extremely low rate.
And if you have credit card bills outstanding, let's say $5,000, $6,000, is that going to factor into it?
Well, if you've been making payments on time, and you're not maxed out on every card. And
what if you are?
Then it's a strike against you, but you got 3 strikes. So
there's, you're out.
Yeah. So there's other factors involved too.
What are the other 2 strikes?
Okay. The 3 things they really look at is ability to repay, your credibility, your credit score, and then also the collateral. Is the home worth it? That nowadays the lenders are just about as strict on the home as they are on the borrower.
Yeah, I will say this: my credit is very good. It's in fact way above normal according to my latest rating or score. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I had it done recently, so I found out what my score is. Very high.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and that's great. But it's they're not going to base it just on credit score. They're also going to look at job. Yeah, and the key thing now is the ability to repay.
I see.
Part they will verify.
Okay, give out your phone number so people can get in touch with you in case they want to buy a house, sell a house, rent a house, do whatever with a house.
All right, or just ask any question on a home.
Yeah.
My direct line phone number is 490-1590. It's a 559 area code, and that's my desk phone. It rolls over to my cell phone if I'm not there.
All right, one more time, slowly, real quick, because we got 30 seconds, and we'll cut off.
559-490-1590.
All right, that's your office number. Don, good to see you. Come back again.
I will.
Sure you will.
This was fun.
Yeah,
thanks.
And you got your radio show on ESPN Radio every Saturday, 9 to 10 in the morning.
Yes, 9:40 a.m.
All right, you got it. Don Scordino of Realty Concepts. Tomorrow, Jackie Parks, Pastor Tobias Brookins of Bethesda Apostolic Church, and the NAACP will be in here tomorrow talking about all the shootings that have taken place last week, the 2 days, Baton Rouge, Minnesota, and then the 5 officers being shot in Dallas. See you tomorrow. Have a great day.
If you have a need to promote your business or event, please consider MeTV Fresno for your next campaign. MeTV reaches over 100,000 of your potential customers in Fresno area every single week. Plus, you can rest assured that your commercial is running in the greatest family-friendly programs of all time. MeTV Fresno delivers a strong, loyal audience ready to buy, and your campaign will cost a fraction of what you're paying for your advertising now. Call me today to find out how affordable MeTV is at 905-1925.
At 2020 Optometry, your vision is their focus. Whether you're 5 or 65, Dr. Tomacasa Grande will get to know you, your lifestyle, and vision needs to ensure that your contacts or eyeglasses are a perfect fit and the right prescription.